Hello and welcome to City Skylines. We are playing Jackson Hole, Wyoming, and I'm your humble host, Christopher Tarantola / Swifty Spider / Architect, depending on where you find me. So, I've done a lot of little tweaking off camera. So I've done some things like I've added an off-ramp and an on-ramp over here that connects to this section of the road. Actually, the off-ramp was there, but I added the on-ramp. Excuse me. And then I added this slip lane with a toll booth over here so that if people want to bypass getting on the freeway to go get back off over here, they can. They can come straight here and then go straight down the side here. I've also extended this park that was along Riverside here. I've extended it all the way along the downtown area, which has increased significantly how many people are visiting it, to the point that it is making a ridiculous amount of money at this point. I could probably just fund my city just on this one park. Now let's go take a look real quick. We have Evergreen Gardens here, and Evergreen Gardens has 896 people this week. It's making about $15,000. So I couldn't fund that was an overstatement, right? But that's a pretty good profit when you consider it's just from having a park now. Here we go. We're making about $2,000 here, and one of the reasons that has increased so much is we've added this pedestrian bridge, which is actually a road, pedestrian road. So cars, as you can see, can drive on it still. Excuse me again. And that allows things like hearses, garbage trucks, and what have you to get there. I did affect which cars could drive on this, although as you can see, we still have some normal cars popping up right here to leave, and I'm not sure what I can do to abate that. I think that's just something I gotta live with, though. Well, okay, what else we got going on? Oh, okay, so I was able to figure out how to do props a little bit better, so I did kind of spiffy up this the base of this skyscraper a little bit, because it was literally just plain Jane. It's an awesome skyscraper, but man, it needs a little bit of love for the base of it here. That being said, we are getting buku's amount of people. 1309 passenger service last week out of this area. I mean, we have a ton of people in this area here. And we also have this park, which is not doing too shabby in and of itself, right? Now, we have a couple pedestrian bridges here and here. I have zoned this area so it can slowly grow as high-end or high-density commercial. So that's going to kind of really start to bridge the gap here. And what else did I do? I also zoned all of this as industrial so I can have more goods production. I'm having some trouble with my industries buildings, and I will go over that in another episode. I'm not even going to address it in this episode. I did also add this cargo station, which is an upgraded cargo station, and I connected it. I have it ready to connect this way, but I connected it all the way along this highway here, as you can see, and I take it to this cargo station here, and so that was also an addition that I did, which I think ought to be helping this cargo station a bit. It's still a really busy cargo station, but at the same time, it's able to more or less handle its load. Now, we do have some traffic going on, and that's mainly still because of getting off of here and then trying to move over. But I think that's about as good as I'm going to be able to really manage that, quite frankly. And we got a little tee here because I put my little star there. I need to mess with that a little bit so that it doesn't give me that symbol there. But I do think it looks really fantastic, don't you? So I added that little star there. I also added some pedestrian access to go around. And I also altered, if you remember, this used to be just going straight like a parabola U here. And I changed that up to, I moved it over so where it did this little S-curve thing, because it actually was made this run a little bit smoother, this circle. And it is extremely busy, but it's working for how many cars are on that circle. It's doing its job. So we got that. I also added this little slip lane here to try and alleviate some of this traffic, and I don't think that worked very much because I think most of this traffic is trying to get to like over here, or over here, you know, all up and down. And I have a lot of traffic issues when it comes to this area here and here, though it has abated quite a bit from what it was. It used to be backed up all along here and all in here, so it's something. I also was able to download and figure out a lot of the train stations. And so this train station here is the one that I had originally wanted for this area, and so I went ahead and put it in, and it changed the look quite a bit. It opened up this back up with all the trees, which I like, and the pedestrians can walk along their pathway again, which I also like. What else? I think that's more or less it. Oh, I know what I did. So I also upgraded and changed this wall, so it's not really different, except that it's a different type of wall. And the shape might be slightly different, but I think it just looked better. I liked it better, so I did that as well. And I was able to finally put in the parking along here, the actual parking spaces, which, as you can see, is working just fine. Here, I didn't actually put in spaces because that's a bus stop, so I figured you wouldn't have parking spaces right there. And then here, it kind of looks a little jinky just because of the way the road is clipping with the stencil, or what do you call it? The decal. That's the thing. But alas, that's such is life. So, but yeah, this train station is being used really well. I also changed what was going on over here. If you remember, the way I had it, it was buses would come along here and they were stacked up all the way back to here. And so what I did is I made it to where there's three bus stops instead of just one. And so I separated the lines out to go to the three different bus stops. Also, this was on this side of the road, so I moved this road out a bit and I stuck it really attached to this road. And then so it's nice and in between there. So I think that looks a lot better. It makes a lot more sense to me that it's right there. And as you can see, it is very well used. And so is this airport. This airport's doing fantastic. As you can see, our population has boomed. It's up to 100,000. I really haven't added any spacing. Like, I haven't really done much more zoning. I haven't done any expansion to the city. That's just from the growth. As you can see, this area here where the offices are and all the little residential and commercial areas, it's really started to level up. It's really getting to full level here. And then, of course, these are the buildings that I placed myself, and I think they look fantastic as well. Yeah, I think that's just about it. So, well, what we're going to do this episode is I think I'm going to start, I'm going to put in a stadium. I want to put in a stadium over here. I'm not sure if this is really the best location because that's already kind of heavily used, but you know what? We're going to do it. We got our tram lines going along here, which I think are great, and we could probably add, we have a train station right here, but we might be able to like add a train station here or something like that. Yeah, I think this will be a great spot to put it. So let's go ahead and look at our stadiums here and see what we have. There's a couple different kinds of stadiums. They're all different shaped. And I think I like this one the most because it has that little corner cut out on the bottom or on all four corners. And so you can put like a metro station in and stuff like that. And I do like having my corners like that. Now I'm not going to put it on, I think, the main road here. I think I'm going to have it kind of off to, on its own, especially being considered that red circle. I want to keep that red circle away from this neighborhood and this neighborhood here. So we're going to push it as close to that rail as possible. I think some of these folks are going to get that noise pollution anyway, and there's only so much I can do about that. I don't think I'm going to push it all the way to the other side of the rail, and I don't think I'm going to really move my rail too much, but you know, I guess the only other alternative I could do is I could also move my stadium out towards this direction more, but I really don't like that. I like that it would be right here. It's kind of right in the middle of all the action, and so I think that's what we're going to do. So let's go ahead and get our roads going. We're going to want to have a road that's like basically right along this rail here. And that's going to be where we actually attach our stadium. Now this road, I'm going to make it, I don't really want to make it a boulevard. It's going to be a skinny road, but I think I might make it a heavy road. And I'm just going to do a small four-lane road, supports medium traffic. I think that's going to be good for us now. We might change it to one of these other ones. We can always change it later. But the important thing to note is it's not going to be a, what you call it? My mind went blank. It's not going to be a medium or a heavy road. Excuse me. So, got that there. I am highly congested today, guys. I'm actually probably even a little sick, but you know, I'm still playing my game and I wanted to keep going with you guys, so I'm gonna just try and pull this down a little bit. I hate that snap. I think that's from my angle snap, so let's take that off, and I bet you, yeah, that solved that problem for me real quick. And now let's go back to our stadium, see about placing it. Here we go. I think right there is good. So now we got our stadium. I'm going to pause the game. So I'm not really ready for it to be active. Let's see here. Looks like we do have. Oh, and we're saving, so bear with it. It's saving. There we go. Okay, so so we got a little bit of topography here, looks like, and that's about it, which isn't too bad, and we can handle that. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and build roads that are nice and perpendicular. It's going to be hard because it's kind of built on this curve here, so there's really no quote-unquote perpendicular here, and that's, on some level, that's okay. It doesn't have to be perfectly perpendicular. But I do want to try and get it as close to it as possible, at least for this side. I think that will work. Yeah, that works just fantastic. Okay, and then we're going to bring this road out here. Here, let's do it from over here. Gorgeous. Okay, so that looks great, and then we'll put on another road right here. And the reason why I'm putting all these roads in is that snap is just in the right wrong place, but we can finagle it here. Is, you know, I'm gonna want to have different entries from different ways, so. You're also going to want to I'm going to want to have a nice heavy pedestrian path to here. And so I need to think that through a little bit. I probably want to put another pedestrian overpass here that goes straight to like the corners here, or I can maybe even stick it in the middle and put a crosswalk there. That way I get all the pedestrian traffic coming from over here. You know, we are connected to this road here and it's got the bike lane, so that's something that we need to probably think about. Probably want to put a bike lane in, and we could really just make it one of these pedestrian things. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. So yeah, I think we'll come right off of this main road here. We can make that like a upgrade that to a street that has bike lanes on it. So let's see. Oh, what's this? This is a new road. Red brick sidewalks, small road. Okay. Yeah, I've added a couple of roads, and I've got a couple different narrow two lane road. I got a couple different assets now, and a couple even different mods that are now part of the game that I didn't have last time I recorded. So this game is quite a bit different now, and I think in good ways than it was before. We can go over that again another time. So let's go ahead and let's try and squeeze right between these buildings so that we don't delete anything. And I'm going to go ahead and page up here. I'm just going to do it by two. And then I'm going to go ahead and turn my angle snapping back on. And page up one more time. See, I got a no pillars mod going here, which is different than what I had before. Go ahead and put a pillar right in the center there, another one there, and then page it back on down. Let's go to about right there, I'd say. And bring it on home. And then we'll go ahead and we will put a crosswalk here. So, crosswalk walk right there. Fantastic. Great. So now we have great bicycle and pedestrian access to our entire downtown area via that avenue there. And the next thing we want to do is we probably want to put some good public transportation in here. So I got a metro system down. So where's my metro system going? Oh, look at that. It's going right by the stadium here. I probably should have looked at that before, but that's fantastic. So now I can just, you know, I don't know if I want to keep that station, if I'm going to want to move it. I'll probably just leave that station there. No use in deleting it. Now, that corner would be the most obvious one. I don't know if I can pull that off or not. I think I can. Now, question is, do I want to have maybe this other one that has, you know, two platformas, so it goes here, but it's also going to like come straight from there. Honestly, I don't think so. I think we're going to go with just a normal. The thing is I do want it to go straight from like the stadium here, straight over. How am I going to pull that off? I'm just thinking through it a little bit here. So if I do this, it'll go on that line, but then I'll add another line that goes like down to here, connects to it, and then I'll have it like loop around to here, and then it'll connect back up to that. So it'll be a really express loop. Yeah, let's do that. That'll help also with tourism, I think, elsewhere. So I wonder if we can stick it like right. Stick it like right there. Let's see how that looks on the surface here. You know, looks okay. I don't like having those trees necessarily right where they are, but I'm not sure I have much of a choice. So I can move it over. That looks actually a lot better right there. So I think that's what I'll do. Just right that. Okay, and let's go ahead and we'll change up. Oh, I deleted my train line up on the surface somehow. Not what I wanted. That's okay. We can build that back, though. So here we go. And we'll just connect that up as if it was always meant to be that way. Right? Gorgeous. Okay. Alright, and gorgeous. Okay. And then we also want to come off of here. Like this. And come in like that. And then we'll come off of that. And, should I loop it like all the way around, or should I just come straight around like this? I think I'll just come straight around like this. So, come in, and bingo. And so now I'll add a line, or create a new line. Well, we can drag line to add a stop. Drag a line to add a stop there. There we go. So it just adds a stop to those two lines, which is what I want. I'll create a new line there. And then I'll have it come to here. And to there. And then on back. Really quick. So just a nice little three-stop expressway. Nothing too crazy. And it goes to this really super busy one. So it probably will hopefully alleviate, having that extra line will hopefully alleviate some of the traffic here as well. So that'll be that. All right. So now that we get the metro hooked up, we're going to want to make sure that we have great access from this train line. I'm not going to build another train line here. Oh, but speaking of trains, we do want to put that rail back. Go. But I do want to have like great access coming down along this road here. I'm probably going to want to put an elevated pedestrian bridge there. I want to take this light out. I don't like this light. I don't like that there's a light there. Let's turn. Come on, turn off. And turn off. Come on, you can turn off. Turn off. There we go. Yeah, let's turn all these off. Any other ones? I think that's it. Okay, great. So, we will, yeah, I want to have great access here. Now, I think they'd probably do okay, but, let's see. I wonder if I could maybe kind of skirt along the rail here. It'd be kind of an awful walk to walk right next to those rail lines. So I actually maybe not do that just for the sake of realism here. Where else could I send it? Yeah, I think I'll just connect right here. It just makes sense that you'd have a pathway right there. And I'll use, I'm going to use something slightly different. I'm going to use this really nifty one here. I love this path. So, no height too high. That's okay. We can go down to, you know. Well, I just want it to be on the ground. So, okay, I'm gonna kind of click here to get it to 0 meters out. Like, I don't like it when it gets stuck on that little thing. It's happened to me before. Okay, and then now I can, because this is not an elevated, you can't elevate this path at all. Okay, and then we're going to take our thing here, and we're just going to really connect the path well. Control Z on that, and really connect the path well. Come on, there we go, there it went. And we'll just make that nice and straight. And so I love that, because it's basically like you're continuing the street, but it's a pedestrian street. And we'll even spiff that up a little bit with some trees here. So let's go ahead and do that. What's this? The conifer. So I'm going to go Control P to turn my prop and tree anarchy on so I can actually like do it there. I don't like that conifer though, so we're going to do something else. We got the poplar here and a papillon. I kind of like that, so it's a nice big tall tree, but it's not too wide. And we'll stick that there, and we'll stick that there. Okay, it looks fantastic, doesn't it? Okay, now I wonder if we want to do some more like along the sides here, something like that. I don't know. We're not going to do that for right now. But let's see here. What's next? So we got good pedestrian access here. We got great metro access. We got good pedestrian bike access from across the freeway there. We want to make sure our trams are set up here so that somebody that's on a tram can get there really easily. And yeah, we got a couple tram stops right there. That'll be fine and dandy. And then what else? Let's see about our buses. So doesn't look like we really have any bus lines. We have one this one bus line, but we don't really have any buses going through here. So I think what we're do is we're gonna just do a short loop that kind of connects to a couple different primary places. So I think we're gonna do where's my there we go. There it is. Okay. So let's see about doing it from here. And we'll kind of just go straight across to here. And then we'll think we'll just go straight on back. I don't like that. Let's see about doing it from the other direction. See if that looks any better. Let's see how that goes. That to me looks a little bit better. I think that'll work a little bit better going that way. You try and avoid these left turns as much as you can, but ultimately there's only so much you can do about that when you have a route like this. So that route will go right and back and forth. So while we will have a lot of pedestrian traffic for people that don't necessarily want to, you'll have a nice little quick bus route there. Let's see what else what do we want. We'll put a second bus route in, and we'll have it connect maybe to like just come to down. Well, we don't want to necessarily replicate what we have with the with this. Maybe we just have it come to like the middle here and come right back. So let's just have it go up here. Come into here and to there. And then we'll have it maybe come up around that way. And then we'll maybe have it come in this way. And I'll maybe give it one more stop here. Give it one more stop right there, and then bring it on home. All right. Now, we'll do one last one, and this one will be. I'm going to create a new line. Oh, where's that create a new line? Create a new line. There we go. Okay, got it. And we're going to have it go over here. And see, I have the three different bus stops here. And then some of those are actually the metro line underneath. I think I'll have it go to this one right here. And just come straight on back. All right. So there's that. I think we'll call that good. I mean, that's pretty well connected. And then what we can do is we can do some parking lot right here. I think that's what we'll do. So we're gonna go and I believe it's actually over here. So I got all these parking spaces, right? But we need to have parking lot road, right? So this one, It's a really huge, big parking lot road. Let's see what that looks like, just bringing it straight across here. Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like it. Not in love with it. Let's see about bringing this straight across and see if we may connect even smaller going this way. You gotta be careful though, I don't want to connect to that. So, I know what I'll do is I'll make it to where it goes this way. Like that. And then I think I'll just do it maybe a little bit at a time. How's that look? It doesn't look too shabby, does it? Maybe I want it a little bit bigger, though. Maybe not the big honker, but maybe do this one. Let's see what this looks like. Yeah, I like that. Now, the only thing I want to do is I probably want to actually just change this road on over to that kind of a road for now. And go back to that. Here we go. That's going to be kind of difficult, isn't it? There we go. And really what you want is you want something that goes right there like that, but I think what we're going to have to do is maybe bring it down to this. It looks really funky, doesn't it? Especially when I got my tree anarchy on, all my trees. So, the way I'm doing this, instead of deleting them one by one, is I'm just getting the movement mod, and I take one tree and I move it around the area, and it just automatically depopulates the one. So if I deleted this stuff, it'll pop back up like that. But yeah, this little area is kind of funky. What am I gonna do with it? So one thing is maybe to delete that and have it come off of here, which is probably what I'll do. Yeah, it's this one here. Just like that. That looks pretty good now. I would like that to be a little bit more even, so let's see if I can't affect that. So let's see here. Let's move that over a little bit. I'm just using the arrow keys to do this. And let's see about moving maybe this one over that way a little bit. And this one over just a wee bit. And let's straighten that up. Alt and then click and drag. Yeah, that looks a little bit better. So, I'd say that's a pretty good parking lot there. Alright, so now that we have our parking... Oh, my goodness, my nose is really killing me. Pardon me, guys, I apologize. So let's see about maybe getting this 8x2 in. It looks like this is made to be a diagonal, but I'm not going to do that. No diagonal for me. We're going to go straight. 90. So I'll click right there. And again, right here. And looks like we're going to need to go down. And then we'll finish that up later. And then we'll go back to our 8. Bingo. And there. And then down to our 4. and we'll finish up that those ends. We'll detail those ends later. And in fact, I think that's it for this episode. Trust that I'm going to finish that up, and I'll reconnect this. But there we go. We got our stadium, and the next episode we'll get to see it. We'll make sure that we take a look at the game and see how we do with it. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it, and I will talk to y'all next time. Bye.